بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد النبي الأمي الأمين وآله وصحبه أجمعين. My brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. I want to tell you a story. It's a magnificent story really about a woman. She was guided to Islam by reading. سبحان الله العظيم. Because there are some people, they are guided to Islam via convincing about Islam. Others, they are guided to Islam by the miracles of Quran and Sunnah maybe. Others, they are guided to Islam by asking other people what is the correct religion, how we know that we are right or wrong. They go asking this man or that man. This woman was guided to Islam by reading. Too much reading. Subhanallah al-Azim. Her name is Margaret Marcos or Maryam Jamila, which means the beautiful Maryam. Maryam Jamila, the beautiful Maryam. She was born in New York, 1934. Her father and mother are German, Jewish German. And she was raised as a Jewish girl, of course. She was going to the Jewish Hacham, which is the priest, and he was teaching her the Jewish religion. While he was teaching her the Jewish religion, he was mentioning to her that your cousins are the Arabs. They are our cousins. They are the sons of Ismail, and we are son of Isaac. She knew this, and she wanted to see her cousins. Who are our cousins? Where are our cousins? In 1948, as you know, the Jewish took Palestine, and there was a war. In 15th of May 1948, the state of Israel were commenced, and her father and mother made a party in New York. In that party, they were very pleased, of course. They invited their friends. Maryam, Margaret, was crying in that party. Subhanallah. She was about 14 years old. She was crying. I mean, why? Her father and mother asked her, why you are crying? She said, you told me, or the Jewish Hacham priest told me that the Arabs are our cousins. And now we took their lands. We killed the men and women and children. Why we did this with our cousins? Subhanallah, that time the mother and father were astonished. How this Margaret, how she was thinking about the way of her thinking. She started to read about Islam. She read many books, subhanallah, while she was Jewish. She read the translation of the Quran. She read many books about Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, peace be upon him, hadith. And she read many books about Islam. She wanted to know everything about Islam. So she went to the library in New York, the public library, and stayed in that library a long time, every day. There was a magazine called Islamic Review. Mawlana Abu al-A'la Mawdudi, he is well-known Indian scholar, of course. He was writing in that magazine that time. She liked the way of his writing, so she sent a message to him. That time, she waited for his answer about 3 months. 3 months. He replied her. She was very happy. And she started to talk to him about Islam. She wrote many letters to him, and he also answered her. Subhanallah, Mawlana, he is in India, and she is in New York, and she is Jewish. Although she was Jewish, he was answering her. This is very important, my brothers and sisters. We don't ignore any message from anyone. We don't know who will be that one, subhanallah. And she was convinced 100% about Islam. She was ready for Islam. One day, at 1961, I'm trying to brief the biography of Maryam Jamila because of your time. One day in 1961, she went to Islamic Center in New York, and she announced her Islam. She declared her Islam. And the Imam told her, "What is your new name?" She told him, "I want to be Maryam." And she was beautiful, so Imam told her, "Okay, you are Maryam and Jamila." Jamila means in Arabic beautiful. You are Maryam Jamila. And she was born again, subhanAllah, in 1961. She was very happy. She went to university to tell the students. She was at that time in the university. She went to the university to tell the Arab students about her Islam, and she gathered with those Arabic students. That time, those Arabic students were following nationalism. That time, Abdel Nasser, he was the president of Egypt. Of course, he was very bad. He was away from Islam. And his followers, the same, were away from Islam. And they were following the Nasserism, which is a branch of nationalism, which is away of Islam, away from Islam. And there was a Jum'ah praying that time in the university, and the students, every week, one student make the khutbah. When the time for Maryam Jamila, of course, she cannot make the khutbah, she wrote the khutbah and gave it to the other student to say the khutbah. And it was great khutbah, magnificent khutbah, about the Arabic nationalism and the relation of Arabic nationalism with Islam. After the khutbah, the students were not satisfied. They told her, "Why you say this about Abdel Nasser? Why you say this about nationalism?" She was trying, yani, "Please, please, please think about it. This Jewish woman, she just converted to Islam. She was convincing the Arabs about the bad behavior of Abdel Nasser, the bad thing about the nationalism, Arabic nationalism, subhanallah al-azim. And she was fighting with them about the what is Islam and what is the Arabic nationalism. And subhanallah, what I really was astonished about, she knew Abdel Nasser, and she talked about Abdel Nasser very, very clearly, better than many Muslims. And she said that he is not loyal for his nation. He wanted to be a well-known president. Whatever he did in Africa, it was not for the sake of Allah. It was for the sake of himself to be a well-known president, to be mentioned a lot in the Arabic countries and non-Arabic countries. I mean, she had very good opinion and correct opinion about Abdel Nasser. Anyhow, once in New York, she was walking and she saw the Tunisian, like this, the Tunisian center, culture center. She was very happy and she entered to the Tunisian Arabic, culture center. She found a woman without hijab and many of liquor, khamr. The Tunisian center, culture center, full of this khamr, of wine. She asked the other woman, "What is this? You are Muslim country, what is this?" She told her, oh no, we are not following Islam now. After Burkeba, we are following other thing. Islam is bad. Islam from the past. Islam. يعني, just see what is this Tunisian woman, Muslim woman, is telling Maryam Jamila about. Subhanallah. It was a test from Allah for Maryam Jamila to see those women and men. They are Arabs, they are Muslims, fathers and grandfathers are Muslims, and they say to Maryam Jamila what they said. Subhanallah, it's a big test. Abu al-A'la, Mawlana, he was trying to go to convince Maryam Jamila that New York at that time, it was not a good place for her to stay. And he told her to come to India to stay with him. He was that time, it's not India, it's really Pakistan. Pakistan, and he was in Lahore. He told her to come to Lahore because after 1947, India was divided to India and Pakistan. East Pakistan, West Pakistan. That time it was the West Pakistan. And he was trying to convince Maryam Jamila to come to Lahore and to live there in Pakistan because yani, that time in New York, the very good Muslims in New York are very little numbers, yani, as we know. Before what we call Sahwa or Revival, that was the condition or the state in the Arabic countries and non-Arabic countries. She was afraid of this and she really refused to do this in the beginning. Subhanallah, for Allah fate, one time father and mother called her. They told her, look Maryam, we cannot afford this house anymore, the money for rent this house. We have to move to other house and there will be no place for you. Subhanallah, that house she was born in and she liked that house. But father and mother told her, no, there is no place for you. You have to find another place. We cannot keep you with us in the new house. So she remembered what Mawlana told her and she sent him a message, I want to come to India to stay with you in Lahore. So she replied her and told her, most welcome, come. That time, of course, she did not have money for airplane, so she had to go via ship. Just imagine from New York to Pakistan via ship. It's very, very, very long way. But subhanAllah, this is the sacrifice that Maryam Jamila made after her Islam. Very big sacrifice. She went via ship and crossed the Atlantic Ocean to the Mediterranean, Alexandria. She, in Alexandria, she entered the house, she entered the one mosque. She was very happy that she is now in Arabic country and want to see the Muslims, all Muslims in Egypt. And she entered the mosque. The Imam asked her, she saw her, she was, before she covered her face. Yani Maryam, after Islam, she wore hijab, of course. She wore the hijab, but she was without covering her face. After that, when she arrived Pakistan, she covered her face and covered all her body. Anyhow, she saw her. He saw her, and realized that she is not Egyptian. Where are you from? She told him, I am from New York. Where are you going? To Pakistan. Why? I want to live there. He told her, are you crazy? Who will leave New York to live in Pakistan? Are you crazy? Pakistan is very bad country. Yani Pakistan is not sophisticated country, is like this, you know. Yani look what the Egyptian Imam tried to do with yani Maryam Jamila, subhanAllah. But she was convinced 100% to go to Pakistan. So she continued to Pakistan and she met Mawlana Abu al-A'la al-Mawdudi. SubhanAllah, this woman knew Islam really. She told Mawlana Abu al-A'la, I am ready to marry if you want to marry me. She knew that Abu al-A'la Maududi had a wife, but she said, I don't care about polygamy. Polygamy is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and I am ready for it. Mawlana, he refused and married her with one of his followers. He called Brother Muhammad Yusuf. Muhammad Yusuf also had a wife and children, so she was a second wife. I want you to read what she wrote about polygamy. Maryam was beautiful. She's American, German, and she was beautiful. I did not see her, but that's what they said. And she was young that time. Although she was young and beautiful, she said, why people refuse polygamy? Polygamy is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Sharia of Islam. It is good for men and women. Why people refuse? She talked about this, and she followed this, because many of us, they talk about Islam very good, but when they practice, they could not do it. But she talked and practiced also this, and she was the second wife of Mawlana Muhammad, of Brother Muhammad Yusuf. And she stayed in Lahore, never went out of Lahore until she died, maybe a couple of years ago or 3 years ago. Maryam Jamila, subhanallah. I had a TV program about her in Jeddah. When I went for the masjid to do the program about Maryam Jamila, and the TV came to the masjid and make it, it is in Arabic, of course. This is a brief translation. It is the real story is longer. I asked myself, is she alive? I did not know that she is alive. I knew, of course, that she is in Lahore, but did she die or she is still alive? I did not know. I tried to call somebody, he's Pakistani, and he answered me, yes, she's alive. Subhanallah, please. This is all happened when I am on my way to the mosque, the masjid. Please give me her number. Okay, I will bring you her number. After maybe half an hour or 20 minutes, he brought me the number. I talked to her. Oh, my sister, how are you? How's everything? And she told me briefly, of course, in a few minutes, her story. When she arrived to Lahore, she was a second woman of Brother Muhammad Yusuf. She had sons and daughters. She had also grand sons and daughters, grandchildren, and she is very, very, very happy. And she lives in the same house with the first woman, and she is very happy. And she told me, the moment I arrived to Lahore, I never moved from Lahore. I don't want to go to America again. I don't want to see New York again. I told her, did you try with your father and mother about Islam? She told me, yes, I tried, but they refused. I think she told me maybe father died or mother died. She's trying with the other, but there's no help. And I asked her, what about the Western culture, the civilization of the West? What do you think about? She told me, it is not true. This civilization is not correct. It is it does not worth to follow it. You people in Arab countries, I know that you are following the Western life, Western civilization, Western way of life. Please don't do it. The way of life of the West people is totally wrong. I am American. I know this very well. And she gave me advice. She told me, please tell your people all this and that. And I did that in the TV program. I told her, please come to Hajj, because she did not make Hajj. She told me, my knees and my legs are very weak, and I cannot make Hajj. I told her, I can prepare for you a private airplane to take you from Pakistan and to make Hajj and to meet your sisters here, Arab sisters. They will be very happy to see you. They will be very happy to hear from you. Yani, she told me, I cannot. I am very old now. That time she was about 74, and when I talked to her, she's about 74. That was, I think, in 2003 or 2004, 13 years ago. And she told me that she authored some books, subhanAllah, story about Khalil. Khalil is the Palestinian man, and his story. She included in his story the case of Palestine since it's began until that day of authoring that book. And she had about 8 or 9 books. No, it's more, I think about 13 books as I now, because this, what I'm telling you now, I read it long time ago, about 13 books, yes. And I told her, what are you doing in Lahore? She told me, I am authoring books. I'm talking to the Pakistani woman about Islam, how to be good Muslim, how Islam is very good, what is different, what is the difference between Islam and Christianity and Jewish, Judaism, and how should you be to be good Muslim, what should you do, how should you think. And she's spending her time like this, subhanAllah. She was very, very happy when she talked to me. And I really read her story, subhanAllah al-Azim. I was telling myself, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided this woman to Islam by reading, a lot of reading. Why our youth, they don't read today? Their information about Islam, very weak. The information of that woman about Islam, even while she was a Jewish, it's much, much, much more about many Muslims' information about Islam today. I told you about Abdel Nasser, and she knew Ahmed ibn Irfan, al-Shaheed, al-Sarhandi, people, the Indian scholars and Mujahideen. She knew about them, and she was negotiating them. She was negotiating people about them. This is what really I was admired of that culture. It's vast culture. It's not culture. It's vast culture. Very nice one. And she had opinion about many things which were about correct, because of, subhanAllah, the first of what she read is Quran. Second is Sunnah. Because many people, they read Quran without Sunnah. Their thought, it's not very good. And she read Quran and Sunnah together, and she read many books. And also I remember that she contacted Brother Sayyid Qutb. He was in prison in Egypt. Yes, I remember, this is very important to know this. And subhanAllah, she sent a message to Brother Sayyid Qutb while he was in prison in Egypt. And the Brother Sayyid Qutb told her to contact Maududi. Yes, this is why she knew, this is how she knew Maududi, by Ustad Sayyid Qutb from the prison in Egypt. That time he was in prison, subhanAllah. And she talked about the Muslim and Muslim countries very good, in a very good way, which really showed that she was a good reader, very good reader. This is the life of Maryam Jamila. I briefed this in about 20 minutes, but in Arabic I did it in about 55 minutes, a long time ago. That's what now in my memory about the story of Maryam Jamila. You need really to go back and read about it. It is in English. There's a book in English about Maryam Jamila and the messages between Maryam Jamila and Mawlana Abu al-A'la Maududi. There's a special book about this also. There's a book about, not a book, maybe in internet, in Google. If you Google it, Google the name of Maryam Jamila, you will find many essays about Maryam Jamila. Her story deserves to be studied, to be taught for the generations, next generations. And it's a strange story. Jewish woman, a German initially woman, and she was born in New York, subhanAllah. She was guided to Islam by a strange way, subhanAllah. She transferred to Pakistan. She was died in Pakistan. She did all what she can do for Islam. And subhanAllah, she liked Islam very much because she knew about Christianity and Judaism. And she knew that the Islam is the correct path and the correct religion. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Sorry, this is a brief story about Maryam Jamila. Inshallah, we'll meet again for other things. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
MashaAllah.
أنا من زمان ما تكلمت بالإنجليزي. فعشان كده شوية يعني